गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ए न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ 10th क्लास, रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट थ्रू ए ग्लास प्रिज्म। इट मींस हाउ रिफ्रैक्शन टेक प्लेस थ्रू ए ग्लास प्रिज्म। सो बिफोर डिस्कसिंग रिफ्रैक्शन ऑफ लाइट थ्रू ए ग्लास प्रिज्म, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू डिस्कस दैट हाउ रिफ्रैक्शन टेक प्लेस थ्रू ए रेक्टेंगुलर ग्लास स्लैब। इन द केस ऑफ सपोज ए बी सी डी इज ए rectangular glass slab. So in the case of rectangular glass slab, this emergent ray, it is the AB is the incident ray and BC is the refracted and CD is the emergent ray. So this emergent ray is parallel with the direction of incident ray. Okay, undeviated incident ray, or we can say the direction of the incident ray. It means emergent ray and this direction of the incident ray, both are parallel with each other, only slightly lateral shift is there. So why both are parallel? Because here AB or BC, two refracting surface, AB or CD, ABC two refracting surface. So these refracting surfaces are so parallel with each other. So that's why this emergent ray and direction of the incident, both are parallel here. Okay. But in the case of the prism, it is not like that. Okay. So suppose it is a prism. A, B, C. It is a prism, a glass prism that is made up by a transparent medium. Okay. So, first we have to discuss that what is the structure of a glass prism. So, a glass prism has two triangular bases, A, B, C. Okay. It is a one triangular and another just opposite side. So, okay. So, two triangular bases and three lateral rectangular surfaces. Okay, so AB, BC or CA, there are three rectangular lateral surfaces. AB is also surface, BC or CA. Okay, so these lateral surfaces are not parallel with each other and they are inclined with each other with the angle. Okay, so AB or CA, both are that lateral surfaces, they are inclined with the angle, that is angle A. Oh, okay. So angle A, that is called the angle of a prism. Okay. So a glass prism has three lateral rectangular surfaces and two triangular bases. Okay. So here we will discuss how refraction take place through a glass prism. So ABC, it is a, we consider a glass prism. So here suppose it is PQ is the incident ray and QR is the refracted ray and RS is the emergent ray. So PQ, QR, RS. Okay, it is the that direction of the light through refraction. Okay, so first we should discuss that here are two surfaces where refraction is taking place. First surface is AB. Here is also refraction taking place. Refraction means, it means when medium will change, direction of the light is also changed. It means bending of the light on changing medium is called the refraction. So it is the PQ is incident ray, it strike on a lateral surface AB. Okay, and this N dash normal. Okay, so here refraction will take place because here medium in changing, we know that it is air or it is the glass. So medium in changing and air is the rarer to the glass. It means glass is denser or air is the rarer medium. So we can say that ray of light passing from rarer to denser medium. And we know that when ray of light pass from rarer to denser medium, it will slightly bend toward the normal. So generally it should be direction if ray of light is undeviated. Okay, but due to refraction, direction of the light will change and it will slightly bend toward the normal. So this, it should be direction but slightly bend toward the normal. Okay, so PQ is the incident ray and this incident ray is making angle with the normal angle I, and angle I is called the angle of incidence. Okay, next this QR is the refracted ray and this QR refracted ray is making angle with the normal. This normal, that is angle R, and angle R is called the angle of refraction. Okay, again this ray of light QR, इट इज द रिफ्रैक्टेड रे, बट फॉर सरफेस ए सी इट इज बिहेव लाइक इंसिडेंट रे. हेयर इज ऑल्सो एट दिस पॉइंट, हेयर इज ऑल्सो रिफ्रैक्शन विल टेक प्लेस. वाई? बिकॉज अगेन मीडियम इज ऑल्सो चेंजिंग. मीडियम चेंजिंग इट मीन्स फ्रॉम ग्लास टू एयर, इट मीन्स रे ऑफ लाइट पासिंग फ्रॉम डेंसर टू रेयर मीडियम. एंड वी नो दैट वेन रे ऑफ लाइट पास फ्रॉम डेंसर टू रेयर, इट विल स्लाइटली वेंट अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल. हेयर टूवर्ड द नॉर्मल, हेयर वेंट अवे फ्रॉम द नॉर्मल. ओके, सो दिस एम एम डस इट इज द नॉर्मल एंड इट इज द इंसिडेंट रे. ओके, फॉर दिस सर्फिसेस एंड इट शुड बी डायरेक्शन ऑफ द दिस आफ्टर हेयर रिफ्रैक्शन. इट मीन्स इट शुड बी डायरेक्शन ऑफ द दिस इमरजेंट रे शुड बी लाइक दिस, बट इट इज नॉट दैट. डायरेक्शन ऑफ द इमरजेंट रे इज दिस. वाई? बिकॉज हेयर ड्यू टू रिफ्रैक्शन दिस रे ऑफ लाइट, इमरजेंट रे ऑफ द लाइट विल slightly bent a bit from the normal and it will be direction. So here we can consider that this emergent ray is making angle with this normal angle E, and angle E is called the angle of emergence. Okay, so angle I angle of incidence, angle R angle of refraction, here is also angle R, it is also angle of refraction. And it is angle E, it's the angle of emergence. Okay, so now we will compare refraction of a light through a glass prism or with the glass slab. Okay, so in the case of glass slab, a rectangular glass slab, direction of the emergent ray and direction of the incident ray both are parallel, only slightly lateral shift is there. But in the case of this glass prism, direction of the incidence ray is not parallel with the direction of emergent ray. This emergent ray is making angle with the direction of incident ray, or we can say that undeviated incident ray, that is the angle D, and this angle D is called the angle of deviation. So here we can say that emergent ray and undeviated incident ray or direction of incident ray are not parallel. Why? Because here two these refracting surface AB or AC, these are so not parallel, they are inclined with each other and they are making angle A, that is called the angle of prism. So that's why these are also made, both surfaces, lateral surfaces are making angle. So that's why direction of the incident ray and emergent ray, these are also making the angle. So that is called angle of deviation. Okay, and this angle A is the angle of prism, angle D is the angle of deviation, angle E is the angle of emergence, angle I angle of incidence, and angle R is angle of refraction, and PQ is the incident ray, QR is the refracted ray, and RS is the emergent ray. I hope you have understood that how refraction takes place through a glass prism.